Story time about the wise men who say only fools rush in to something that would save their life. And that is the recordings of the vision of God from Habakkuk 2. That'll be as glory covering the earth. Good news. Yep, it's foretold. It's true. Yep. So grab your Mickey. Hold on to him tight and grab your Minnie. I don't know where. I think my puppy got Minnie. I'm always worried about my puppy getting Minnie. One of these days, he might really get her. Shake her up. But praise the Lord. It's time for the glory of God to start covering the earth as waters cover the sea, as grass covers the lands, and the lilies cover the pond. So it's all about exalting love and the good things within all of us, and to start looking at our commonalities instead of our differences. We must stand together, and these are the days when the great falling away of the Bible is a good thing. The wheat and the tares cannot grow together. Racism must end. All lives matter. And the world is crying out for the end of racism. So now I'm the one that will help. And people must leave all churches, all mosques, all temples, any ideology that condemns another. And because for years I was a subtle racist. I'd see somebody that I knew was a different faith wearing a this or that or a dot on their head or whatever. And I'd think, oh, wow, those people are stupid. Those people are going to hell. They don't know. They've heard the truth, I'm sure. But they don't know, and that's it for them. I was a pure racist. I repent of that, and Paul repented of being a person that put others down like dogs. But racists all need to be put down like dogs in love. But it's time to leave every mosque, every temple, every church that preaches. If you're not in our social club, you're going to hell, because they got their words all mixed up. They're mixing their words and wixing their merds all up. So it's time to get rid of in the world so the people can get along for the next 1,000 years. The kingdom age has begun, and watch my materials. I explain it all. But love from love, hope from hope, and peace from peace. Kick back now and enjoy this story time, because this is a very special story time. Mickey here want to dance as King David dance. Yip, 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 yippery. Let the big jubilee now begin, because time is now on our side. The days have been cut short so that there won't be the lawless one who I have revealed. Watch my other videos. He won't come, and neither will Armageddon. That won't come. It's all erasable. The Bible says so. Malachi 4:6, that if the hearts of the fathers turn to the children, children to the fathers, and everybody starts loving everybody, then God will not let the days as Noah, literal, that otherwise would be coming. He will not let that prosper, because his love through us will be saving planet Earth. One heartbeat at a time. It's a small world after all. And just know that all the fears and tears that we have, Mickey says, they can all be wiped away by love. So our good shepherd over all men of the risen John 10:15-16, the good shepherd over all the flocks of man, not just the Christians. He's never been just the Lord of Christians. And he has no condemnation in his mouth. He says to everyone, he says, I love you. And he says, I forgive your iniquity. I shall remember it no more. I shall write my law and my love on your heart. I shall be your God. You shall be my people. And then he says, and no one shall need to be taught of me anymore. Religion, he is ending right now as it has been known. Welcoming days of John Lennon. Imagine. Because that's what it is, a brotherhood of man arising in love. If that was not possible, then every word that Christ prayed for in the Garden of Gethsemane in John 17:20, his most passionate prayer, he wouldn't have known what the heck he was talking about. Why pray for something that was not even possible? It is possible for all of us to arise in love. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten in love. So whosoever would believe in love and walk in love would be under no condemnation. That's what walking with the Spirit means. And then that's it. They would have the blessing of the kingdom age new covenant. And know that Haggai 2:2 and Jeremiah 1:10 predicted this, that the Lord would pull down all the mountains, lift up all the valleys, so everybody could be on the same exact ground before one loving God over all people. And that's the way it always was in the beginning. That's the way it shall be at the end. And the bottom line, as he arises in the splendor of his magnificence, his beneficence and magnificence, they combine for the awesome wow factor to the 10th degree times lots more zeros. And as he arises in the splendor of his love, the radiance of his charity and benevolence, it's a flood. And he wants to flood that all over earth. So God wants to tear down all the kingdoms of our imaginations. Haggai 2:2, Jeremiah 1:10. Leave nothing left standing except love alone. And bottom line is he wants down with religion. Get rid of religion and uplift spirituality without borders. Where we look at commonalities within one another instead of differences. It's time to stop all the bullshit, false prophet garbage, because everybody is a false prophet. There has never been anyone who has not been a false prophet, and there is never anyone who has not been vile or evil. All of us have fallen. And the good news is, people, our righteousness is as filthy rags. And that means that our faith, our religion, our beliefs, what we've done good for, charity, whatever, it's all as filthy rags. The Bible, Isaiah, rightly foretold, compared to Christ's perfect love that stands up and transcends it all. For it is written that he is the sower of the seed of love, and he has overtaken his end time reaper, who I am. And it's time for love to pave the way. Yay! I'm gonna like this story time, so get ready, hold on. And if I'm making any difference out there in the world, the Lord has restored all things, including the order of Melchizedek. And that's where Abraham was giving money to one who brought him enlightenment. Now I'm bringing enlightenment, because if it's true what I'm saying, the veil has been ripped, and the distortional false god of love is now revealed to be not condemning, wrathful at all. That's all been metaphoric, and I prove it in my other videos. But one thing for sure, the kingdom age covenant that he wrote, it was written correctly to Israel and all mankind. It says so, Jeremiah 32, 27. Two chapters, 31, 32, all that covenant. And it was always a blessing towards all mankind. And bottom line is, it got switched, just like Esau had his blessing stolen from the younger brother, Jacob. And that's what happened. Christians stole it from Judaism. And they said, "We are Israel, and the prophecy is fulfilled now." And they snubbed that it was written to all mankind. They said, "We are Israel and all mankind," and they switched it. And then they snubbed that it was for the latter days. It says so, Jeremiah 31, 1. And if God didn't give it to Israel and all mankind, he'd be a liar. So anyways, love from love, hope from hope. I am the Latter-day Daniel of Daniel 12, 13, who embraces my destiny. So I won't go crazy, so you won't have to go crazy. So let's just get along in the sandbox, can't we, little beanie? Come along, my little pretty. So kick back, enjoy, and I do hope that you get something from me. And if you do, please let the spirit of love guide you. I got to go to work today. I shouldn't complain. I got a job. Praise the Lord. I'm happy about that. But I saw meat and fish door to door in a truck with a freezer. I don't even need a freezer out there right now. It's 20 degrees below zero in Canada right now, pretty well. But you transfer me. send me $10,000, someone rich that has a heart that wants to give me a chance to quit being a door-to-door salesman and start being the fisher of all men that I am. And that is written and foretold in Habakkuk 2, King James. The Lord said unto all the people of the world of the Joshua generation who's just getting ready to go in to inherit their inheritance and to receive it. And people have to do nothing to do that except to keep their love light on, commit not blasphemy of the Holy Ghost. Otherwise, people would have no light for our next body made light. And that's not good because we're angels. We're man angels. And our shining is greater than that of the former hosts. First our last our first. We are the last. So we shall be first. So much so that because of our more stronger authority in God, in a sense, for sure. And because our shining is greater than the hosts, we shall judge the fallen before us in love. And it's always been about love. So $2 e-transfer is all right, too. $5. Somebody showed me they care. I haven't had no one leaving me comments except Shasa from House of Beloved, really, who is the world's other gospel writer. And she's revealed to be that and foretold in Revelation 12 by a proper interpretation of that. And anyways, the wind of prophecy interpretation is full, and the tide of the spirit of Daniel is with me. And I am Daniel. And anyone that comes forth and says, hey, I'm Elijah. First off, I'm not the last one. The last one's still slated. He's one of the two witnesses that would die in Jerusalem. Not really die, but, you know, just stay still for 3 days. And people would be celebrating so much, to sending gifts to one another. But praise the Lord, that's not going to be a future. That's an erasable future, only if we go towards Armageddon, where we are going, people, is heal the world with Michael Jackson. The prophecy there of Isaiah 2 is the centerpiece of that song from the 80s. And he was a prophet. I bet none of you knew that that whole song was a prophecy of us beating our swords of the Spirit into sickles of love, into plowshares for the harvest of love, so that all people can finally have total validation for who they are and be who they are, exactly as they are. All the Lord wants is to raise up your love, because the last sentence of the Kingdom Age Covenant, by the way, that sends Satan to the pit for 1,000 years, because God says, I'm going to forgive your iniquity and remember it no more. If God remembered it, he'd be a liar. So the devil can't be the accuser of the brethren anymore, people. Not going to happen. So, time, come along, little doggies. And so enjoy this program. Love from love, hope from hope. And remember, e-transfer $1 million as quickly as possible, people.
Thank you.